Hello, and welcome to Drawing with me, Sir Michael Caine. Today, we're going to draw Captain Marvel. Now, I've not seen this movie, and the thing that you need to understand is you can't... Don't confuse it with Shazam, because he's called Captain Marvel too, and it's very confusing for someone like me, who's did grow up with the DC, the Marvel characters, but it's okay. We're going to try... See, she's gotten a lot of flack on the internet. Because some people say she has a smile. The trailer looks boring, but I've not seen the movie. So, okay, I'm not going to judge it. But we're going to draw Captain Marvel. So we're going to give her some hair. It looks like she's got some lots of blonde hair. And it just kind of hangs from her forehead. The top of her head goes right out of her head. It's like a cheer pet. Just a cheer pet. I bet all cheer pets love Captain Marvel. I have a little strand coming down here. Like it's blowing into breeze, you see, because she's powerful. The power's just coming off. It's blowing this little stray hair. Now, let's see. She seems to have that thousand-yard stare. She just stares right into your soul, you see. But she means business. She's going to have eyebrows. Her brow. A little furrow, you see, because she's looking right at you. But you can't read her soul. Because she's looking right into your soul, but you can't look into hers. I find that to be true of most women. They look right into me, they say, Sir Michael Caine, we know what you're thinking. And most of the time they're right. I just want some brandy and some cigars. And a good book. Or just Netflix and chill. And on Netflix, you know, you can watch anything you want. As long as they upload it. And they'll probably upload Captain Marvel. So, Captain Marvel here. She's got a suit. We don't know what it's made of. It's probably leather or something. Who knows? But she's just kind of daring you to walk past her. She's blocking your path, you see. And we're just gonna give her the basic thing here. Now, you know, with the Marvel movies, it's not like the old comic books where you got four color process comic books, you know, the primary colors. No. Things are a little more complicated because they're trying to make it fit in the real world. So there's lots of seams. So we gotta put seams. We're gonna put the seams everywhere. By the neck, across her bosom. And there's a star. Now, she doesn't get her powers from the wizard Shazam, like the other Captain Marvel. No, she gets it from the Marvel Universe. Where Spider-Man lives. Where Wolverine lives. It's a different world than... There we go. Than the DC characters. Now, she's not happy with you. Because she's not happy with... The people online saying the movie sucks because they haven't seen it yet. But there's always drama. She's tired of the drama. You see, she's sad inside. Look, there's a little superhero tear. Maybe one over here too. See, now there's going to be some red. We might have to throw a little color on this too because it doesn't really make much sense without the color. That's unbalanced. We got to have balance. But we've got. I'm just using some reference here. And look, there's a seam coming here. And there's a seam coming here. A little folds. You see, she's probably put in a suitcase coming back from outer space. And it got all folded up. But she folded because she's a lady. She folded it all nice and neat. But all towards emanated from the star here on her bosoms. She's got a little red stripe coming up to here. And she has a seam here. Now, the seams will confuse you. They'll draw your attention down here. All over. Oh, I forgot some seams. There's lots of seams here. Lots of folds in the fabric. We don't know what's going on. It's beyond our comprehension. You see, you know, sometimes when I look at suits, I think they don't look comfortable. But this looks like it's made by a seamstress. I bet this is a zipper. We'll put a little zipper there. Now, I don't know what else to do with this except look for more seams that I've missed. Oh, here's one. not enough seams. Now, like her hair is coming down. It looks all kind of feathery coming down here. Now, remember, you can't see her emotions. She only see what she lets you see, right here. Let's put some color on this. We're going to put some, see, this is colorful. Oh, but not right there. Can't paint over it because then it'll be confusing, you see. So we're going to put this here. This could be the movie poster for the Japanese market. Could be for the kids, because I know the kids want to go see this. The kids laughed at Captain Marvel. Yeah, the other day I was at the market. And the kids, I said, the kids, you like the Captain Marvel? And they looked at me. They didn't say much. But I do. I knew they loved her. I knew they did. A little gold on the star. And then we got to have the blue, you see. Because it's blue, the suit. I really do have to color in the blue. Because now it looks like Captain Marvel. If you didn't catch it before, now you catch it. Now, I bet on Friday nights, Captain Marvel, she likes to go out dancing. She probably goes to the discotheque. She could fight anywhere in the world because of the power, you know. And she probably goes to Tijuana, probably South America, to the discotheques. And she has a great time. She doesn't show it, you see. Except when she sheds a little tear. How much fun she's had. Go here. Now, we can't leave that white because this should just look pale. There we go. Now, I think this movie opens up this Friday, so I'll be going to see it, and I'm going to take this picture with me to see how, in a live action, how close I came. But just remember, she has feelings too. And don't let it go and give her a hard time just because she's doing the best she can. Right, that's enough for me. Thank you for drawing with me, Sir Michael Caine, on this week's episode, Drawing Captain Marvel. Thank you.